So if they're allowing a patient to use the assistance, then what's the risk to the patient?
The risk is very simple, and we've seen study after study in recent years demonstrate that the more cost sharing that is borne by that employee, their family, the patient, the bigger impact there is to medication adherence. There was a 2020 study from Janssen, U.S. Transparency Report, that identified prescription abandonment rates for new patients. When cost sharing increases, patients are less likely to fill a prescription, and otherwise they're abandoning their medications. 8% when the cost is under $10. 52% will abandon when the cost is between $125 to $250, and 69% when the cost exceeds $250. So the key takeaway there is, as we see more cost shift in the scenario of a copay accumulator adjustment program, there's a greater probability that that patient may abandon their, in most cases, high-cost specialty medications, which really, I would say, through the financial assistance programs, through various pharmaceutical manufacturers, intended to remove that financial hurdle from the patient and help enable them greater access and affordability. But conversely, we're seeing a different phenomenon play out with these copay accumulator adjustment programs as the field is being shifted and the more cost is being borne by that patient. We're seeing correlations to medication adherence declining. In other words, they're abandoning their medications. We've also seen studies in recent years that demonstrated that more than half of Americans today cannot afford an unexpected $400 or $500 medical bill, just cash out of pocket. So when we think about the challenges around the cost of healthcare overall, and it's all forms of healthcare, it could be hospital, it could be medications, it could be anything. You know, what we're trying to reimagine is how can we take that burden off our employees' back or off the member and patient's back? And unfortunately, these copay accumulator adjustment programs, the unintended consequences is actually playing right into the hands of these studies that are demonstrating a decline in medication adherence. And there's another study in 2019 that was excellent that was actually published in the American Journal of Managed Care, and it was volume 25, number 7. But, you know, basically it was a deep dive looking at the impact of copay accumulator adjustment programs on specialty drug adherence. And really the bottom line conclusion was, after the copay accumulator adjustment program, members that are on a consumer-directed health plan with a health savings account, those patients on autoimmune drugs had significantly lower monthly fill rates, higher risk of discontinuation, and lower PDCs than did the PPO patients, suggesting that copay accumulator adjustment programs have the potential to negatively affect specialty drug utilization by those patients that need it. So I'll stop there, but happy to elaborate further.